In this episode of Adobe Spotlight, I'm going to show you a new app that makes it very simple to create animations. It's called Animate from Audio. Let's take a look. So here I am on adobe.com/express. This is Adobe Express. And if you haven't already watched my other Adobe Spotlight videos on Adobe Express, you really need to do that. It's a wonderful tool. But Adobe recently created an Adobe Express app called Animate from Audio. But as of right now, you can't find it just by looking at the templates or the quick actions that are on Adobe Express. That's okay. I'll show you how to find it. As long as you're signed in to your Adobe Express account, and I would recommend that you do so using your school-provided or district-provided Adobe account. But once you're signed in, you can just go up to your browser search bar and type in Animate from Audio, and it should find the tool. So I'll click on it, it opens up, and you'll notice that Animate from Audio is still in beta, so it's not quite yet finished. But while it's being finished, we can still use it. Now that it's loaded up, you can see that I get a character. I've got a snowman. And the idea behind Adobe Animate from Audio is that you can choose a character, record your voice, or upload audio, and then your voice and the character will be synced and animated automatically. If you've seen my Adobe Spotlight videos on Adobe Character Animator, some of these characters will look familiar. Adobe Character Animator is a related tool to Animate from Audio, but they are still separate, distinct tools. So let's take a look at how I could customize a character, record my voice, and produce an animated video. Here at the right, we have a panel, and it has three main tabs. Let's start with character. I'm going to select a different character. I like this snowman, but as you can see, there are several different categories I can choose from, including humans, we've got creatures, we've got some food, and we have some emojis. And we can choose from all of these when we're picking a character. I'm gonna go with this smiley face with the party hat. That looks good. Now that I've chosen my character, I can click here on background to change up the background. Right now I have the background called festival, but I could switch to frontier, living room, horizon, mountains. There's just all of these wonderful backgrounds that I can choose from, including some indoor backgrounds that very well could work as a school or as a classroom. We've got a sports stadium, a snowy scene, just a whole bunch of wonderful backgrounds to choose from. In addition to these backgrounds, we can also choose just one straight color. So blue, we've got orange, green, purple, etc. There's even a color wheel down here that you can use to choose a custom color. Now, going back up to the top of the list of backgrounds, there's also the option to upload an image from your computer and make that be your background for your animation. So imagine taking a photo of the inside of your classroom or in front of a landmark in your city. Wouldn't that be cool to make a real-world setting the background for your animated character? In my case, I'm just gonna choose summer, just click on it, and that's now the background for my animation. Okay, we've looked at the character tab and the background tab. Let's move on now to the size tab. Here I can choose from different output sizes for the different social media websites like Facebook or YouTube, Pinterest, LinkedIn, etc. And then once you've selected one of those, you can then click through to change the dimensions of your video. In my case, I'm going to switch to YouTube and I'm gonna go to landscape. I think that looks great. And now I'm ready to start recording. Before I do record though, I do want to show you that you can click and drag your character to a different point in the scene that you've created. And you can also resize the character. So I'm gonna keep my character basically in the middle of this scene, but I do want the character to be just about as big as can be. I'm pretty happy with that. Now it's time to provide the audio for my Animate from Audio animation. And you can see there are two main options to choose from. I could click record and record my audio right now, live, and that's a great option, or I could choose an audio file that's been pre-recorded. So maybe I've gone to a friend or neighbor's house and recorded them speaking. I could then take that recording and upload it into Adobe Animate from Audio, and it would sync up the audio file with the character that I've selected. Also, notice this little option here, Enhance Speech. If you turn that on, Adobe Animate from Audio will automatically try to clean up the quality of your recording. So if there are background sounds, like maybe the wind is blowing, or there's lightning, or there are people talking in the distance, or a radio playing, Adobe will try to automatically fade those sounds out, and it works very well. It's also going to try to reduce echo and maybe adjust the volume. Maybe you've got the volume too high or too low. It's going to do its best to try to fix that. So in many cases, that's a good option to choose. In my case, I'm in a quiet room. It should work just fine. So I'm going to leave that off. All right, I'm ready to record. I'm going to click record. I get a countdown. Students, we've had a wonderful year of Spanish. I'm so proud of you and impressed with the great progress that you've made over the last year. And now it's summertime. And as you go on your summer vacations and your summer break, I want to challenge you to keep practicing. If you'll do that on a weekly basis, when you come back next year, you'll be ready to dive right in to Spanish Level 2, and you'll have a wonderful second year of Spanish. So enjoy your vacation, but practice your Spanish. Okay, I clicked done. Notice that there was also a pause button, so you can use that to gather your thoughts, to record the next part of your video if you want to. Now that I've clicked done, Adobe Animate from Audio is processing my voice. It's also processing the image that I selected and creating a video and then syncing the video to my voice. Now, as I was recording that, some of you probably noticed that the mouth of the smiley face wasn't moving. It wasn't matching my mouth and my voice. Don't worry, that's okay. All of that processing happens after the fact, and that's what's happening right now. So in just a minute, when Adobe Animate from Audio finishes this process, I'll be able to show you the finished results. And it's finished. Here we have the animation that I've created. I can click play. Students, we've had a wonderful year of Spanish. I'm so proud of you and impressed with the great progress that you've made over the last year. And now it's summertime. And as you go on your summer vacations and your summer break, I want to challenge you to keep practicing. If you'll do that on a weekly basis, when you come back next year, you'll be ready to dive right in to Spanish Level 2, and you'll have a wonderful second year of Spanish. So enjoy your vacation, but practice your Spanish. Okay, so that's my finished animation. I am very happy with it, but there are a few things I can do to edit it or change it up at this point. The first thing is I can cut out the end of the video if I want to by clicking and dragging this little handle to the left. That'll cut out the last few seconds of just dead air. And I can do the same thing at the beginning of the video just by using this handle. Unfortunately, if there's a mistake in the middle of the recording, you're not going to be able to cut that out. If it's important enough to you, you could just click back to editing and re-record. You can also use back to editing to change the character that's synced to your voice. And by doing that, you shouldn't have to re-record your audio. Okay, I'm happy with the results, so I'm going to click download. And again, Adobe Animate from Audio is going to process all of this content once again. But when it's done, it's going to download a copy of this to my computer. And it's going to be a real video, not just an online video that only exists in the cloud. No, this is going to be an MP4 video that actually resides on the hard drive of my computer. What's the advantage of that? Well, at that point, if you have the video on your computer hard drive, you're in control of what happens next. You could upload it to YouTube or another video hosting website online. You could also edit it in iMovie or Adobe Premiere or any other video editor. So there are some real advantages to having an actual video on your computer and not just one that exists only in the cloud. Okay, it looks like it's finished downloading and I can click on it to open it up. Here is my real actual video. It's an MP4. I can take it full screen if I want to, and I can play it. Students, we've had a wonderful year of Spanish. I'm so proud of you. So I hope that you'll think about some of the ways that you could use Adobe Animate from Audio. I think it's the perfect tool for creating a fun, quick announcement that you want to give out to the students or to parents. It's great for creating reminders, but I think teachers could also use this to create some short, simple educational content. Maybe to teach a simple principle, introduce a concept or a new chapter in the textbook, or a new unit in the curriculum. And students could certainly use Adobe Animate from Audio in their projects to summarize the plot of a novel that they're reading, or to explain a scientific concept or a historical event. I think there are many different ways that we can use Animate from Audio creatively in the classroom. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed learning about Adobe Animate from Audio, and I hope you'll join me in the next episode of Adobe Spotlight.